I think I've done it. I think I've made the single best item anyone has ever made with a laser engraver ever since the beginning of time. Look at that. I don't know if you can see, but that's lasered through the white paint and you can see the actual stainless steel through it. And if you don't know what that is, it's the Millennium Falcon. And honestly, I think this is the best thing I have ever made. So stick around, guys, and I'll show you exactly how I made it. Right, so what we're going to need to do first of all, you're going to need to get yourself a sheet of metal. Whatever metal it is, it doesn't matter. Your laser, unless you have a fiber laser, you're not going to be able to mark the metal. So get anything you want. I was going to get copper because this would look really nice with copper, but the price of copper sheets was absolutely unbelievable. This is just a cheap sheet I got as stainless steel. It was quite a big sheet I got. I have cut it down. So the bigger piece I'm going to be using for the main project, this I'm just going to be using as a tester. Yeah, and I'm going to be putting this obviously in one of these photo frames, as you've seen. This is just a cheap photo frame I got from IKEA. So what you'll want to do, you just want to take your photo frame apart and you do just want to make sure that your sheet is going to fit inside the frame nicely. But my plan is to also, I'm going to remove that and I'm going to have my big piece fit in there perfectly. So I've cut it down to fit this frame perfectly. So when it's done, you'll see it all in there, hopefully. Okay, so let's get into it. We've got our photo frame, we've got our piece of metal all measured up and ready to go. We just need to paint this now. Again, with this, it's up to you how you want to paint it. Like I do in all my videos, I'm going to be using an airbrush. I'm just going to be using this as a test piece to see what power and speeds I'm going to need. What you'll need to do now before you actually paint it to get a nice even coat on it, just get yourself a bit of sandpaper and we're just going to rough up the surface a bit. You know, it doesn't matter, you don't want it smooth, you don't want it tidy, just rough that area up a bit. So then when we apply our paint, so we'll give this a couple of minutes to dry and then what we'll do, we'll go to the laser, we'll just load up a quick design, run a couple of speed and power tests, and we'll see which one we're going to be using for this. Right, so we've got our piece of metal now loaded into our laser. Everything's set up and ready to go. I'm going to be just running a quick 5mm square. And I've set up 10 lines per millimeter, so it's not like anything detailed. It's just to see if whatever speeds and powers I put in there are going to remove the paint. So I'm going to home this now. So the first test I'm going to try is 50% power at 1000 speed. And I'm just going to put my glasses on. Okay, let's have a look at that. So we can see there that has actually engraved that really well. I mean, already that looks perfect. So I know I can either lower the power or increase the speed. Okay, now for the second test, I think I'm going to keep the speed at 50%. I'm going to increase the power to 2500 millimeters a minute. And we'll give that a go. For some reason, it's changed the size of it. I don't know why. But again, that looks all right. So let me just get in a little closer. That doesn't look too bad. Okay, that's all set up again. Now for the third test, I'm gonna go 75% power with a 3000 millimeters a minute speed. So we'll try that. So that's that top one there. I think that looks good to me. Okay, test number four, I'm going to go 80% power with a speed of 4,500. I'm just going to keep doing this basically till I get a failure, then I'm just going to work back from there. Nice and quick. And that was that one there. That also looks really good. Okay, now test number five, I'm actually going to reduce the power to 70% and then up the speed to 5,500 millimeters a minute. And yeah, let's see what this one turns out. I think I might get a failure here. I'm not seeing it failing anywhere, really. I'm gonna move that up and then we're gonna run a couple more tests underneath. Now, I don't really wanna go any speed above 5,500 millimeters a minute because the whole machine will start shaking like crazy. So I'm going to keep this at 5500 millimeters a minute, but I'm actually going to bring the power down to 50%, and we'll see how that works. So I can see there, let me bring that up. Let me bring this a little bit closer for you to see. Now you see that one I just burnt there, the edges look all right, but the middle of it doesn't. Now these lot of beer, all these look like they've all done successfully. I think what I'm going to do is just keep the speed at 5500 millimeters a minute, and I'm just going to keep the power so between 50 and 70. So I'll probably go 65% power because I know it'll work. And like I said, the speed, I don't want to go above 5500. So yeah. So for this, I'm going to go 5500 millimeters a minute and 65% on the, on the 5 watt diode laser this is. So now we've run our test pieces on our scrap piece of metal. All we need to do now is just get the right size sheet of metal that's going to fit in our frame and get it painted black. And luckily, here's one I've made earlier. So again, it's just the bare metal on the back and this completely painted black on the front. Don't know if you can see there, I've marked a very small X in the exact center of this, because when I'm going to engrave this now, I basically want to place this in the exact right place. So I've marked the center just so when I can home the machine, I can find the center, I can find the corner, and then I'll run a quick frame around the outside and I'll know that's the exact right place. I've got the design loaded up on the computer. I'll put it up on the screen now. And again, I'll put this on Patreon. So if anybody wants to download it, it'll be there available for you. So check below in the description for that. So I'm just going to take this now to the laser engraver. We'll get it all set up, ready, aligned, and then we're ready to run. Right, so we've got the design loaded up in laser GRBL. I've got the laser itself actually ready to go. I just need to make sure, so I've homed the laser, so I can now center that. You might not be able to see it there, but the little cross is directly in the center. There, I can press center on laser GRBL. Now you probably can't see that on the camera there, but looking down, I can see, yep, that's perfectly there in the center. I can go to corner and I should bring it down to this bottom corner. Again, I'll turn the beam on. Yep, and I'll run a quick frame around it all. So again, what that'll do, that'll turn the laser on and I'll be able to see it run around. All right, I'm happy with exactly where that has gone. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to run the engraving. Again, we're going to go at the speed, was it? Speed of 5,500 millimeters a minute with the power of 65%. Now it says this is going to take about 2 hours to run. So again, I'm going to run a time lapse and hopefully it'll take a photo of it all the way through. And fingers crossed the battery doesn't actually die on the camera. All right, guys, we'll see you in a couple of hours. After nearly 3 hours, it is done, and this might be the best thing I have ever made with my laser engravers or 3D printers or vinyl cutters or anything. Honestly, this is amazing. Have a look at this. How good is that? That is absolutely stunning. That has come out so clean. I wasn't sure of it. I thought with the speed I was going to go, it wasn't going to engrave that clear. But look at it. You can read all the text and everything, all the details that has come out. This was made with a 150-pound laser engraver, guys. Honestly, that is amazing. Like, I'm honestly gobsmacked. I just don't know what to say. I'm speechless. It's amazing. Like, it's metal. But look at that, guys. Where the laser engraver has removed all the white paint, you can see all the details, and it just looks absolutely amazing. With the white paint there, you can see the reflection of the actual metal through it all. Yeah, absolutely amazed by that. All we need to do now is get it in the frame. So now we've got our IKEA frame. Let's just move that. Our IKEA frame. And all we're going to really want is the acrylic and the frame itself. Oh, yeah, and the back as well.
What I'm going to do, I think, to try and protect this from getting scratched at all, I'm going to put the acrylic over the top. And then if we lay it in this way, I'm hopefully not going to get it caught on anything or scratched. Oh, there we go, it's in. And then it's just a case of putting the back on. Folding these down. And it's done.
Honestly, I am so stoked with how that turned out. It's framed perfectly in there as well. You can see everything. I haven't overshot the design, or I haven't made it too small. That is perfect, guys. I'm going to be making so many more of these with different designs and everything. Again, this design, I'll put the design on my Patreon feed. If you want access to it, I'll give a link to the Patreon so you can just download that there. But yeah, best thing I've ever made, guys.